guys.
Welcome back to our YouTube channel. If you're new here,
hi guys, welcome back to our YouTube channel. I don't understand what this ginger
I'm just excited because this ginger, right? She's just looking.
And it's enough of the paparazzi, guys. So today we're going to be talking about questions you need to ask that person, that special someone, before you get married to that person.
Before you get to the altar.
Yeah, before you get.
So that when you get into the marriage, it will not seem to you like what you order versus what you get. Do you understand? So these are vital questions you need to discuss, not even ask. Well, ask and discuss. You get. So that you have a lucid understanding of what your partner thinks about them, because of course you might think something different and your partner will think something different, but for both of you to be on the same page, you all need to have a sit down and discuss about them. So we're going to be sharing with you five, and at the end of this video we'll have a good news for you guys. There's a good news coming up.
Make sure you will be involved in
you get want to involve you guys in that video that is coming, in that information that is coming up. So before we get into the video, please hit the subscribe button, guys.
Absolutely, and do not forget to subscribe, okay? Like this video, share this video as well. So number one question you need to ask is, are you willing to start a family? And I'm talking about not just getting married, having kids. Are you willing to start a family? Some people want to get married because their parents want them to get married, because, you know, society pressure, or, you know, for various reasons. People marry for various reasons, you know, and not everyone wants to have kids.
So just like she said, it's important to know if your partner is ready, mentally ready to start up a family.
Yeah,
family means different things to different people.
Exactly.
So you need to ask your partner, what's your idea of a family? What do you picture when, what pops up in your head when you hear start a family? You get, so with their own understanding, you'll be able to do plus and minus. If there's a way you can correct their understanding, if there's a way you can chip in some knowledge. Marriage is an institution, like you already know, so you all are there to learn. If there are things you need to, you know, chip in, it's not just about you, you're of age and you're ready for marriage. My father-in-law was asking me some questions the other day, and I let him to understand that nobody is pressuring me to get married. Physically, I'm still young, forget about the age part. Bless, I don't the old school, so when it comes to age, well, physically, I'm still young, and nobody is pressuring me to get married. I do not want to get married because I feel like I've attained the age of marriage. I want to get married because, first of all, I have seen somebody whose personality, you know, meets mine. You get, why are you smiling? I'm not trying to bubble you, I'm speaking. Whose personality meets mine, and I feel like it would be a mistake for me to just let her go because it might take me forever. I might not find somebody like her, and then it's not, that could mean two things: tie her down because you feel like she's good for you. What about you being good for her? Do you understand? So when it comes to marriage, it's not about you asking your partner asking you to, and you inculcate, or rather explaining, what's your understanding of starting a family, your understanding of marriage is your partner. Now both of you have this understanding of how it is, then both of you will come together. This is my view, your view, my view. Come to, you know that program,
your view now, TVC.
Yes,
what
your view, my view, that you come together and have a family goal.
The second question you need to put in mind is finances. You know, what cause problems in marriage?
Money. Money. I feel like this this topic should even come on its own, because
The question,
finances in marriage, seems like I keep cutting you off, my love. Sorry.
Yeah, but it's fine, no problem. I don't want you to forget what you have.
Finances in marriage is a very, very big issue.
First, with your partner, how is our finances going to be like? Are we going to have a joint account? Are we going to have our personal account? Are we going to be, you know, having a different account for our kids, you know, or how do we do it? Discuss it. Like, okay, is your money is your money our money? Is my money my money? You know, how the female gender, you know, my gender doesn't feel to disappoint me when it comes to money. So you guys should discuss about it, because I mean, if both of you are working, then you guys have to know whose income is, you know, higher than the other. So how much percentage are we going to be dropping or contributing in the month? Is joint account very important? How do you see, am I supposed to be the one to provide, you know, as a man? Do you see provision to be a sole responsibility of a man? When I contribute, do you feel it as a lady? When I contribute, do you feel like you're being disrespected? Ask those questions.
Okay, I'm gonna say this, right? This is something that somebody asked me, and I think we were trying to have a conversation about something. She was like, would you allow your wife to foot bills in the house?
A very, very tricky question.
And I was like, what kind of question is that?
Yeah.
You get. Now, that is where discussing finances is very, very important.
Very important. Yeah. Because, in fact, it cannot be overemphasized.
Because right now, let me speak from my experiences.
Yeah.
You get. If I want to check where my ATM is, I'm sure that it's with her. Do you understand? Because when I need money, I already know that I have money, but it's not just with me.
Mm-hmm.
You get. When she needs money, even if she doesn't have money, there's my ATM is with her. She knows our financial goals. Do you understand? Things we need to do with money.
Mm-hmm.
So if she wants to use money, she's going to apply sense.
Mm-hmm.
You get. I want to use this money, but I cannot use this money to this extent.
Mm-hmm.
I have to take the just part
limit
of this.
Yeah.
Yes.
You understand? And not like he tells me to have a limit.
I think we've never discussed finances.
We've never even discussed
not even once.
Financial limits.
Yes.
We've never ever discussed it, but nobody has ever come up with any issue. Because I'm very, if you know me before now, you already know that me, I'm
when it comes
I'm
to
a
money.
Manager,
God,
money. That one, I manage enough. Right from my secondary school days, ask my secondary school classmates. If I achuku my classmates, he calls me manager up to today. Because then, the way I used to manage my provision, till now, it's even applied to finances and everything, which is very good. So, yes, let's not.
So we've never had issues when it comes to finances.
Limits. Yeah, or financial complaints.
And that is how it's going to be, right? Except when we reach a point where we need to sit down and draw it finance. I just feel like the finances we might have is, you know, okay, finances for expenditure, finances for...
And that one varies based on the economy. That's why we actually would even sit down and discuss that.
Yes.
Because the main thing is understanding, okay, yes, have we discussed if we want to have a joint account? Yes. Have we discussed who is going to be providing and who is going to be doing this and that? Yes,
exactly,
we have.
Yes.
These are questions that are very, very important. As time goes, you know, the questions get more advanced. Like,
mm-hmm.
you guys are already practicing that financial rules, right, that you
yes.
guys have set for yourself.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe as economy change, bills change, you know, rate of things change,
or the
you guys might want
or
to
or the other person's salary.
Oh yeah, increases or reduces.
Decreases,
so
you need to
now start discussing how to, you know, improve on needs, you know. But this is very important. Third question I'd like you not to forget is how sex is very important in relationship, right? So how sexually marriage, I beg your pardon. How sexually active are you? How many days are we going to be intimate?
How 7 days a week. Pa pa pa.
Yeah.
Pa,
how do you see
pa.
Romance? You know, see, let me be honest with you, but before I started dating this man, I was very, very shy when it comes to issue of sex, romance.
Conversation and all
sex, yes, in relationship. I do not like to be, when it comes to sexual conversations, romance, all of those things, I'm very like quick to say, just change topic, let's have something else. Do you get? I'm quick to saying that. But when I started dating this man, and then the relationship started getting pretty intense, and if you don't know, we are already introduced, and if you don't know, we have done our traditional marriage, but we'll give you guys a clip later, and our wedding is really very, very close. You guys will get those videos, right? So I started to have a change of mindset that, these things are very important. People will tell you, discuss these things, discuss intimacy with your partner. So if you haven't done that, please make sure to discuss it.
Definitely.
Don't be like me, that will be very shy. Discuss it. See, I'm even discussing it in front of the camera now to tell you that shyness has gone away, guys. So discuss that intimacy, very important.
Mm-hmm.
In fact, we don't need to say much about that, because I feel like if you're an adult watching us, obviously you're an adult, you already know what
our videos are made for adults, not children. So.
Yeah, so that's it. Fourth thing you also need to talk about is in-law relationship. How do you navigate through in-law relationship? Because different backgrounds, different families, different culture. In our case, different cultures.
Yes. Samuel, you know, in our culture, in our culture, there are some things that we cannot do. We cannot just let go. But, you know, sometimes when you meet families that are very understanding, they will bend rules for you out of love for you and for their children. You get?
Yeah.
I almost say for their daughter.
Yeah.
I don't have to make it personal. You get?
Yeah.
So that is very important. How do you navigate the relationship between your in-laws? It's very cool. Sometimes I forget to call my father-in-law. She reminds me that, you've not called my dad. And sometimes she forgets to call my mom.
Yeah.
I remind her, you haven't spoken to my mom. Or when last did you speak? Oh, she'll be like, oh my God, I forgot. I'm going to call her now. You get?
Mm-hmm.
So this helps in keeping in church.
Yeah, so you need to understand family. Your in-laws, so you know how to follow them, because these are now your new parents, additional parents, you know, to the ones you already have. You know, you have to bring them close because you're already in love with their daughter or their son. So obviously you need to do the need to understand, ask your partners, who are they? Let them explain to you the kind of person that they are.
Yes.
So that you know how to follow them, you know. And you make mistakes, you make them angry, they'll make you angry, you learn from it, you know, that apologize is where, and
that,
grow.
That is where, okay, let me just put it this way, right? Either of you, your sole purpose is to make sure that your in-law is in love with your partner. That is your sole responsibility. So another one is exes.
Discuss about your exes.
Let's just put exes, friends and besties. Yes. Let's just attach three
everything
of them together.
Yes.
Exes, friends and besties. I'm just going to say this. You don't have any bestie. When you're married, your husband, your wife is your bestie. There should not be anybody you talk to things first before your partner.
Exactly.
No matter how funny it may sound to your partner, always say it. And your partner needs to learn how to be open-minded, to be able to receive whatever it is you're bringing to them. Don't be this rigid person that your partner. Yes, don't be judgmental. That your partner will find difficult to talk to. Do you understand?
Mm-hmm.
Be simple, approachable, and open-minded.
Mm-hmm.
You understand? So friends outside the marriage, when you have opposite sex as friends, your opposite sex as friends should also know your partner.
Yeah.
You get? Should also know your partner, and you should be able to, that friend should be able to install in your partner that there's nothing involved. Do you get?
Yes.
If you are my female friend and my partner is not comfortable about you, auntie, I will cut you off.
Mm-hmm.
That is just the truth.
Yeah.
So if you're my friend and you're trying to flirt with me I'm making my partner inconvenient, you understand? I will cut you off.
Yeah.
Period.
Mm-hmm.
So that is how it is, right? Mm-hmm.
So the last but not the least thing you should consider or ask your partner, question to ask your partner rather, before saying I do or before getting married, is how do you manage conflict?
Are you the one that do bass, 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 bass?
Like when bass. You're angry, oh, how God. Do you manage conflict? Do you react immediately? Do you hit people? Like, do you insult people's family? You know, how do you react? Discuss
anger,
it. What's
how,
your anger
how
management
good is your
like?
In anger fact,
this is a whole
excuse.
Lot. You see all these things we're breaking down, trying to cut the video, make it short. It's a whole video on its own. Like,
I just feel like we're not even trying to explain to them, right?
We're
just trying
to tell
them
rush it
questions
off.
That they should just ask. How yeah, should discuss?
Right. But if I really need to sit down, but only me or not even with him, because you know that we both can talk, right? If I need to sit down, it should take at least 10 minutes to be able to do just on one topic, to discuss what it actually means. Discuss how they manage conflict, how your partner manage conflict. If he's hot-tempered, you know, if he's like what we're learning in class yesterday, discuss their temperament. Very, very important. Are they sanguine? Are they
melancholy? Are they choleric?
Is it phlegmatic?
Phlegmatic.
Discuss all of these things. Understand their weaknesses and their strengths and help them work on them.
I used to tell people that the one of the main aim of coming together with somebody is how to better each other's lives.
Mm-hmm.
They are not coming to come and
suppress somebody's dream.
Yes, or producing children. How do that person that you're married to look back and be like, wow, ever since I got married, my life has drastically changed because I got married to this person. Do you understand? How that is a thing of pride. Are you able to, you know, affect your partner's life positively?
Also, I know that I said this is the last but not the least, but also, and let me just add this, Jara, don't forget to discuss what your partner sees divorce as.
Oh, that one is
very important.
Let's not deviate first.
But discuss that one, Sha. Yes. Do you understand? Very, very important. Okay. If you need us to go more like deep into this topic, please make sure to drop it in the comment section because there's no time. We don't want this video to be too long. Thank you so much for watching, babe. We're going to shut it down here.
So I should not say what I want to say.
Yeah, don't say it. I'm not the one editing.
Jesus. The chief editor.
Guys, we have a lot to say, but we don't want it to be too long so that it doesn't bore you guys. But
so
if you want us to go to let
of
us
this
know
video, let
section,
us know. Okay.
Yeah.
So I think right, we're gonna be going back to. We did a video on the five love languages.
Dropping the link in.
Yes,
the video.
And I think we're going to be revisiting this video shortly after our marriage because it is very important. Sometimes
wedding bells are ringing
in relationship and in marriage, people tend to have different opinions and different attitude towards things. Yeah. Yet in relationships, she believe that if things doesn't work out, yeah, how can we go your separate ways? But marriage is for life.
Uh-huh.
So we're gonna be revisiting that topic again and having more light on it as couple. We're gonna wait till we get married in a couple of months from now. So that is the good news. We're getting married in a couple of months from now.
Sooner than you expect. Don't listen to
we'll not tell you guys the month yet, but it's close.
Yeah.
Very close. So guys, we've come to the end of this video. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe.
Yes, please drop your comment also, okay? Tell us what you think. If you want us to do part two, let us know as well.
If there are some things you want us to talk about, tell us. This one's just, we also want to go.
Bye. We'll be talking to you tomorrow. Bye guys.